go.
I'm supposed to be the soldier who never blows his composure, even though I hold the weight of the whole world on my shoulders. I ain't never supposed to show it. My coin's supposed to know it. Even if it means going toe to toe with the Benzino, it don't matter. I never drag him in battles that I can handle unless I absolutely have to. I'm supposed to set an example. I need to be the leader. My crew is for me to guide him. Some shit ever just pop off. I'm supposed to be beside him. That job said I tried to squash it. It was too late to stop it. There's a certain line you just don't cross, and he crossed it. I heard him say Haley's name on a song, and I just lost it. It was crazy. This shit with gravy on some Jay-Z and Nas shit. And even though the battle was won, I feel like we lost
it. Right, I'm gonna move up. We need to move up.
Dad.
Hang on. Whereabouts? Oh, whereabouts? Whereabouts?
But not running my mouth. I'm talking about something that I knew nothing about.
The horse.
Straight told me stay out.
Move up.
This wasn't my beef, so I did. I just fell back, watched the grit in my teeth while he's all over TV. Now I'm talking to a man who literally saved my life. Like, fuck it, I understand. This is business, and this shit just isn't none of my business. I still know when this shit will pop off, but in a minute.
Yes, nice one, Adam.
There used to be a time when you could just say a rhyme and wouldn't have to worry about one of your people dying. But now it's elevated, cause once you put someone's kids in it, shit gets escalated. It ain't just worth no more, is it? It's a different ballgame. You call names and you ain't just rapping. You try to stop the 50 and job me from happening. Me and Dre had sat with him, kicked it and had a chat with him and asked him not to start. He wasn't going to go after him until Josh started gapping. The magazines I was stabbing. Smash him, mash on him, let him have it. Meanwhile, my attention's
again
in another direction. Some receptionist said the source who answers phone to this desk has an erection for me and thinks that I'll be his resurrection. Tries to blow the dust off his mic and make a new record. But now he's fucked the game up, cause one of the ways I came up was through that publication. The same one that made me famous. Now the owner of it has got a grudge against me for nothing. But fuck it, that motherfucker could get it too.
The right window of the bar. The right window.
Just inherited 50's beef with Murder Inc. He's inherited mine, which is fine. Ain't like either of us mine. We still have soldiers that's on the front line.
Adam. Just have to touch the fire and run back here.
Strictly to show they support us. Maybe shout them out in the rap.
Fire.
Up in the chorus to show them we love them back. And let them know how important it is to have Runyon Avenue soldiers up in our corners. The loyalty to us is worth more than any award is. But I ain't trying to have none of these people heard and murdered. It ain't words that I can think of a perfect way to word it. Did it just say that I love y'all too much to see the verdict? I'll walk away.
Move up on the ball.
Let it go any further. But don't get it twisted, it's not a plea that I'm copping. I'm just willing to be the bigger man. If y'all can quit popping off at your jaws with a knocking, cause frankly I'm sick of talking, I'm not
right window. Someone
else's coughing rest on my conscience.
Back right side of the ball. No, you out. Adam, I'm gonna push left to kill my brother.
Never blows his composure, even though I hold the weight of the whole world on my shoulders. I ain't never supposed to show it. My crew ain't supposed to know it. If it means going toe to toe with the bitch.
Haley's name on the song and I just lost it. It's crazy, this shit went wavy on some Jay-Z and Nas shit. And even though the battle was won, I feel like we lost it. I spent so much energy on it, honestly I'm exhausted. And I'm so caught in it, I almost feel I'm the one who caused it. This ain't what I'm in hip-hop for, it's not why I gotten it. That was never my object for someone to get killed. Why would I want to destroy something I helped build? It wasn't my intentions were good. I went through my whole career without ever mentioning it. Frustrates told me stay out. This just wasn't my beef, so I did. I just fell back, watched the grit in my teeth while he's all over TV. Now I'm talking to a man who literally saved my life. Like, fuck it, I understand. This is business, and this shit just isn't none of my business. I still know when this shit can pop off at any minute.
Back of the ball!
There used to be a time when you could just say a rhyme and wouldn't have to worry about one of your people dying. But now it's celebrated, cause once you put someone's kids in it, the shit gets escalated. It ain't just words no more, is it? It's a different ballgame. You call names and you ain't just rapping.
Good that guy.
You try to stop the 50 and Javi from happening. Me and Dre had sat with him, kicked it and had a chat with him and asked him not to start it. He wasn't gonna go after him until Josh started gabbing in magazines how we stabbed him. Fuck, 50 smash him, mash on him, let him have it. Meanwhile, my attention's pulled in another direction. Some receptionist at the source who answers phone to this desk has an infection for me and thinks that I'll be his resurrection. Tries to blow the dust off his mic and
make
it.
Now he's fucking dead. That's gotta be a kill. Yeah!
Got a grudge against me for nothing. Fuck the kid too. Fuck you. But I'm so busy being pissed off, I don't stop to think. We just inherited 50's beat with Murder Inc. And he's inherited mine. Which is fine. Ain't the people of his mind. We're still like soldiers, it's on the front line. He's willing to die for us as soon as we give the orders. Never to expose. Strictly to show his supporters. Maybe shout him out when the rapper up in the chorus to show him.
See, Max Townsend on the left, right? Oi, left. Let's see Simpson. Just on the left. The church. You see him, yeah? Behind the tree. See that? Right, back of the church, right in the corner. My gun hasn't got the accuracy to get left window. Left window, yeah. Right, hang on. I'll suppress him. Right, ready, go. Is that an SR25?
Yeah.
Yeah, nice. I got one too. Right, Adam, you go around the corner, on the windows on the right, just shoot. Look, back of the church, sitting down. Great jumper.
You got me? Haley, I know.
Right, yeah, there you go. Nice one.
And I know you miss your dad when I'm gone, but I'm trying to give you the life that I never had. I can see you sad, even when you smile, even when you laugh.
Right.
I can see it in your eyes, deep inside you want to cry, but you're scared. I ain't there, daddy's with you in your prayers. Don't you cry, wipe your tears, daddy's here.
Yeah. Oh, it's the second time I have to read this book.
Mama's always on the news. I try to keep you sheltered from it, but somehow it seems the harder that I try to do that, the more it backfires on me. All the things growing up is daddy had to see. Daddy don't want you to see, but you see just as much as he did. We did not plan it to be this way.
All right, smoke. Use the advantage of the smoke and move up.
I don't see us
ever being together ever again. Where to though? Hang on. Right, I'm gonna go on the left off. Use the advantage and move up. Use it. It's never meant to be, but it's just something we have no control over, and that's what destiny is. But no more worries, rest your head and go to sleep. Maybe one day we'll wake up and this will all just be a dream. Now, just little baby, don't you cry. Everything's gonna be alright. Stiffen that up, put it up, little baby. I told ya, daddy's here to hold ya through the night. I know mommy's not here right now, and we don't know why. We feel how we feel inside. It may seem a little crazy, pretty baby, but I promise mama's gonna be alright. So, I remember that. Yeah, I got my brother! Yeah! Bradley!
I'll never forget that Christmas. I sat up the whole night crying because daddy felt like a bum. See, daddy had a job, but his job was to keep the food on the table for you and mom. And at the time, every house that we lived in either kept getting broken into and robbed or shot up on the block. And your mom was saving money for you in a jar, trying to start a piggy bank for you so you could go to college. Almost had $1,000 till someone broke in and stole it. And I know it hurt so bad it broke your mama's heart. And it seemed like everything was just starting to fall apart. Mom and dad was arguing a lot, so mama moved back on the Chalmers in a flat one-bedroom apartment, and dad moved back to the other side of 8 Mile on Novara. And that's when daddy went to California with his CD and met Dr. Dre and flew you and mama out to see me. But daddy had to work, you and mama had to leave me. Then you started seeing daddy on the TV and mama didn't like it. And you and Laney were too young to understand it. Papa was a rolling stone, mama developed a habit, and it all happened too fast for either one of us to grab it. I'm just sorry you were there and had to witness it firsthand, cause all I ever wanted to do was just make you proud. Now I'm sitting in this empty house, just reminiscing, looking at your baby pictures. It just trips me out to see how much you both have grown. It's almost like your sisters now. Wow, I guess you pretty much are. And daddy's still here. Laney, I'm talking to you too. Daddy's still here. I like the sound of that.